I've been driving this train. Years in this lane, there's no stopping this flame, cause I came.
Finally, your big day has arrived, and you are filled with excitement, and you are just glowing. And as you sit back and wait for your name to be called, you reflect on the sacrifices, but most of all, the pride that you exude just from this day alone. You reflect back on your hard work and dedication, the late night studying, going, driving in the car and having your books and studying, going to the library, going out to dinner, going out to lunch and studying, going to group studies. You recall all the sacrifices that you made, but you also reflect on, you may be the first family member to graduate. You may be the first in your generation to graduate, whether it be high school, college, whatever it is. Please think about Aunt Essie, who is traveling on a plane miles away to come to this proud moment, to be able to come there and watch her babe cross the stage. Be mindful of Medea, who has traveled miles away to come there to see her baby walk proudly across the stage. Your mom and dad, think about the sacrifices they made. If you were in high school, band practices, or if you were in sports, or just making sure you got there to school each day, make sure you had lunch money. Reflect back on all of those things. Reflect on people who are traveling from out of town just to see you, just to be with you, just to support you. Because they are proud of you. Because you have done your studies proudly. So why not carry this through the end? Speaking of carrying it through the end, I want to talk to you graduates about something. Turn up the volume. Go ahead. Please, turn up the volume. I want to talk to you all about that graduation cap. The graduation cap is also known as the academic cap, the mortar board, you know, because it looks like a brick mason. You know, the brick masons hold, you know how they hold the mortar. That is what that graduation cap is called. It's very important the way that you wear that cap on your head. The academic cap is to be flat on your head. It is to be flat on your head, parallel to the ground. Flat on your hair, parallel to the ground. 1 inch above your eyebrows. 1 inch above your eyebrows. That means it's not cocked to the right. It's not cocked to the left. It's not cocked to the back. It's not cocked and flipped and twisted. It's not bunched up if you have a hairstyle that you know graduation day is coming. You should have already tried on that cap and gown. Please, graduates. This is coming from an old school G. Okay? Be proud. handicap or mortarboard is associated with the successful completion of a degree, a tertiary education, formal academia, and scholarly achievement. Now let's talk about that robe. The robe is also called academic regalia. The robe is called academic regalia. And everyone starts off with a tassel on the right. You see people tip their caps in the air after graduation. Well, the tassel is worn on the right and they move it to the left, except for graduate students. It stays on the left during the entire ceremony. Now, why do they tip the head in salutation? Why do they do that? Also known as doffing. They tip the head in salutation in respect to other academics and scholars. So, when you get ready to walk across this stage, did you sit and reflect on all the great things and sacrifices that you made? Know that others have made sacrifices to get you where you're able to walk across that stage. Your parents, your guardians, maybe even your siblings, maybe your co-workers or your job, or the military, but someone helped to get you there. Pell grants, scholarships, sports, academic scholarships, and so forth. Someone else helped to get you there for you to be able to walk across that stage. So do them proud as well as yourself by respecting the academic regalia that you wear when you walk across that stage, because you are representing others, not just yourself. And please, do me a favor. Just do me one small favor. Please don't let me see this right here. This is the wrong way to wear your mortarboard or academic cap. This is the correct way. Now, congratulations to each and every one of you all, whether you are getting an associate's degree, bachelor's degree, master's degree, PhD, and so forth. Whatever academic that you are receiving, I wish you all the best. And make sure that you pay it forward. Pay it forward. Happy graduation day, graduates.